The House Committee on the Judiciary is introducing two articles of impeachment charging the President of the United States, Donald J. Trump, with committing high crimes and misdemeanors. The first article is for abuse of power. This gives rise to the second article of impeachment for obstruction of Congress.
So that's it. Two accusations that are so vague they can mean anything and nothing, which is the point. After all, when there is no crime, you got to leave it to the imagination. And boy, is this open to interpretation. It's like a Rorschach test for the blind, which suits the media perfectly. Remember how this process was reverse engineered. It wasn't, here's a crime, let's impeach. It was, let's impeach and hope we find the crime. It's the holiday reboot of let's pass the bill to see what's in it. Pelosi's last big hit. And what a flop. Worse than Angry Birds 2. And we knew it, yet we still had to carry the farce, despite it featuring clowns who joked about Barron and played dishonestly edited clips of Trump. But while the press tortured viewers by pretending it mattered, one question remained. Why didn't the Republicans just bolt? After all, we all knew it was just a stupid skit designed to make Dems feel good, since they're immune to feeling stupid. The rest of us are left with what cops call the mess, meaning when thieves break into a house and find zilch, the only thing left to do is trash the place. Hence the amorphous abuse of power, which anyone can now use on the Dems, and they should. I mean, when you move forward with a three-year witch trial, knowing the only support will be partisan and therefore doomed to fail, while boasting that you'll keep doing it forever, isn't that an abuse of power? It's certainly an abuse of America's patience, institutions, trust, and cohesion, which makes it another media-assisted hoax. Collusion, Covington, Kavanaugh, now this. If you want to find the lie, just look where the media points its cameras. I have a theory, Dana, I would like to share with you.
Love your theories.
I do too. Okay, so I believe this impeachment process satisfies the media while helping Trump in key battleground states, correct?
Yes.
So what does that sound like? It reminds me of CNN and MSNBC, primarily Morning Joe, doing nonstop mocking coverage of Trump, which the media and their ratings enjoyed, but got him elected. So are they too stupid? Is Morning Joe and CNN just too stupid to see that they're reelecting Trump?
Mm-hmm. I see what you've done there with your theory.
Yes. It's a leading question, just like the impeachment inquiry.
Absolutely, the polling shows that two things. Nationally, Republicans and Democrats, nothing has changed, okay?
Yeah.
So the numbers are the exact same as they were not even just 3 months ago when impeachment was announced, but 3 years ago when the president was elected. And the number of people who disapprove of the presidency is at like 53%.
Right.
And what did Hillary Clinton get in the popular vote? About that number. Nothing has been persuasive on either side. Both sides are completely locked in, except in one place, and that is in the key battleground states. Michigan, Wisconsin, Pennsylvania. And those three states, in the last 3 months, impeachment has absolutely hurt the Democrats.
Mm-hmm.
And it has helped President Trump. If President Trump were to lose next November, it will not be because of impeachment.
Right.
That will absolutely not be the case. And also, it was just announced that the House Judiciary Committee is going to move so quickly that tomorrow night at 7 p.m. is when they're going to start the markup. That means in the committee, they're basically saying, here's the final details of what we're going to go forward. So who says Congress can't move quickly?
Yes, exactly.
But I think the reason they want to move quickly is they want to rip the Band-Aid off, get this over with, because they know that politically, while it was important for their base, they need to move on so that they can try to, I guess, argue on the merits going into November.
Don't tell Andrew Johnson. I think he was impeached in 3 days. But
that was the fourth time.
but I would say this about the numbers that Dana was citing accurately, that
I said thank you.
Well, of course. but I do think that if you look at the numbers and almost half the country favoring impeachment and removal, that's unprecedented. I mean, I go back to Bill Clinton, and it was only like 29%
to the media
at the max. No, I think the media is on both sides of this. I think there's conservative media, there's liberal, or I don't know, whatever.
Sure, but
there's all kinds of media where people want to be simply have their pre-existing opinions affirmed.
Mm-hmm.
But I will say that to my mind, when you look at an allegation like bribery, Greg, and you say, oh,
good point.
I don't see the bribery charge, right? And I see this big bucket.
Mm-hmm.
I would say one, oh, well, gee, I guess it wasn't a fishing expedition. It was done in good faith, and this is what they think. Or two, that when you look at abuse of power, bribery would be included in such a charge, the so-called quid pro quo allegation, right?
No, but yeah, you're right, though. The bribery just kind of went away. Do we have a bribery montage that we could throw to at this point that makes this look incredibly sophisticated?
The evidence shows an impeachable offense, bribery, abuse of power, and obstruction of justice.
There was a lot of evidence of bribery.
There's a substantial amount of evidence on the abuse of power, on the question of bribery.
You can call this extortion, call it bribery. It's all the same thing.
Did the president's demands on Ukraine constitute bribery?
Treason, bribery, or acts of omission. And in this case, it's clearly one of those.
Treason, bribery, high crimes, and misdemeanors.
What happened to the bribery?
Well, I think it's in that bucket I was talking about.
Yeah, but
abuse
of
power.
But I think the bucket is so amorphous that the Dems are now swimming in that bucket.
No, I think that they were actually, as I said, acting in good faith. Not a fishing expedition.
I think they kicked the bucket.
You know, but I will say that I can't believe that we're talking about left-wing media, right-wing media, how this report gets interpreted. Well, you know, all of this, even what we're talking about here, what about the fact that it's Trump's people bringing these charges from Vinland to Sondland to Taylor to you? I mean, these are
deep state lawn. Let me get Jesse in here. Jesse, the first impeachment probably in history based on emotional trauma.
Yeah, I mean, the two articles really are, we hate you and we can't beat you. not anything here. What do you have? First, you had no collusion. Then there was no extortion, no bribery. They're just settling on things, Juan. They say obstruction of justice because Trump said, I'll see you in court. Every president tells Congress, I'll see you in court. You can't impeach someone for saying, let a judge decide. And then the other one, abuse of power. By that standard, every single president could have been impeached by that very low standard. They tried to rush this thing. The American people saw that it was flimsy, and then they lost interest in it. And now everyone's just talking about football and the Irishman. This is what's going to happen. 10 of these Democrats in Trump districts now in the House, they want to censure. They don't even want to vote on impeachment. They're nervous. And like you said, you're right. Trump was losing to these three Democratic contenders in these battleground states a month ago,
right.
And now he's beating them all by a lot. And he's had a great year in 2019. He killed Baghdadi, blockbuster job numbers. Now they're passing new NAFTA. I mean, and he exposed the deep state, which we haven't even gotten into. So it's been a good year.
Let me talk to, you know, Emily. If you're like me, before I watch a movie, I always go to Wikipedia to look at the plot summary because I don't like surprises.
Oh, I do. I never look at Wikipedia.
I feel like we already knew the plot and we're watching this thing unfold. We already know where it's going to go, which is in the Senate and go, pfft.
This is true, which is why it's such a surprise that bribery isn't in there. And I hear what you're saying, which is that you are saying it's included in this. But I think that's what is difficult for the average citizen to wrap their brain around, is the fact that this writing is very amorphous. It is ambiguous. What does this mean? Wherefore, President Trump, he's demonstrated he will remain a threat to national security. I'm used to a strategy that hits elements of a crime, that presents to a jury, here are the elements of this crime, here's the code that is the law, and here is therefore why this defendant committed a crime. What we have here is... If it's persuasive, the answer is it's not.
It's, you know what goes back to what we said before? These are what-ifers. What the ifers. They don't know what could happen, so they, what if this happens? This could happen in the future. They're trying to prosecute him for future crimes. It's just like Minority Report, that great movie with Tom Cruise.
I'm going to have to go to Wikipedia and read the plot summary.
Find the plot.
Yeah, but I'm going to say, if you're looking about, how does this play out? I think he gets impeached.
Well, we shall see, Juan.